On today's video, we're going to talk about how do you follow up with your customers without being annoying. Hi, it's Jason Everett from Business Refuel, where we give you all the tools you need to fuel up for the business week ahead. Well, we've all been there where we're waiting to hear back from a client about a proposal, and we need to make a phone call to follow up with them. But they've done surveys and have found that the number one most annoying phone call that a business owner can get is a follow-up phone call. So how do you follow up without being annoying and have flawless follow-up? Well, there's something called a VBR. It stands for Valid Business Reason. And when you have a valid business reason for calling a client, instead of just calling to follow up on the contract, think of what else can you call them for. Now, when I was first trained on this, they said things like, what if you found a relevant magazine article? Or what if you found something in the newspaper? I know that sounds very old school and dated, but believe it or not, depending on the type of client you have, if you took the time to cut out a magazine article or send them something from a newspaper, for crying out loud, and you've personally mailed it to them, it keeps you top of mind. It helps you follow up with them without really having to follow up. Now, in today's modern age, you can do something a heck of a lot more sophisticated than that. In fact, I recommend something called a Google Alert. Now, if you don't know what a Google Alert is, it's a way that you can kind of trigger a search automatically, and Google will email you results as they change online. So just like when you do a Google search, and there's a lot of things that are on there, what a Google Alert says is it will alert you to new things that come up. So you can either follow a person, you can follow a company, or you can follow an industry. So for example, if you're following with somebody in the mortgage industry, you could set a Google Alert for their name. And if anything shows up online that has their name, you will get an email about it and it will give you a reason to forward it to them. Or maybe their company has pressworthy information or shows up in the news. You can then forward them that article. Or if you just want to watch the mortgage industry in general and notice when rates drop or rates go up, notice it'll give you a valid business reason now to contact that client. Say, hey, I noticed that rates were recently on the rise. How is that impacting your business? Now you've got a legitimate valid business reason to be in front of that client without just calling and saying, hey, I'm calling to follow up with you about that contract we were talking about signing. So again, I hope that tip was helpful for you, and you probably have some other great ideas about what are other valid business reasons to be in front of your customer. Do me a favor, put them in the comment section below, because I love seeing ideas from you people just like you that are watching these videos. Now, if you found this valuable, my guess is there are other people just like you that would love to see you share this video so they can get the same value out of it. So please do me a favor, like this video right now, and then go ahead and share it. And if you want to see more great content like this, go on to facebook.com/businessrefuel and youtube.com/businessrefuel and subscribe to our channel there for more great videos.